was the record before us, and here we are pre-recorded because we did this a few weeks ago because we're not here at the moment, are we? We're away on that. I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Stephen Merchant.
Hello there.
And Carl Pilkington.
He's not actually with us. He's on the. He'll be in some of the best of clips that will be coming up shortly.
Yeah, this is just us, isn't it?
This is just us. We did this. When did we do this, Rick? A couple of weeks back.
Hold on, what is it?
It's the 27th today.
Yeah,
well, I enjoyed Christmas. I loved Christmas.
I loved Christmas.
I had a great time. What did you get?
Loads of presents.
So did
and I'm glad they made it to number one.
I'm really glad.
Stroke, he, she.
Yeah, I'm really glad that the pop idols, Cliff Richard, Westlife, made it to number one.
Bo Selecta. Yeah, just delete that.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we're going to play some of the best of, some of the greatest moments of the last 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Ever heard on XFM 104.9. What about this? Do you remember this one?
Oh, which one is it?
I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Steve Merchant. Over there, Carl Pilkington. The man who believes anything. I think it might be a condition due to his little round head.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of like, it might be a new condition that we can call cranial spherity. And it presses on his lobes, and the only sort of upshot of that is he's normal in every way, but he believes everything he reads or yeah. sees on Anna Nova.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Talking of which, Rick, I don't really follow the news.
No.
It's mainly boring, isn't it? Wars and stuff.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Well, yeah. Well, it is a war. It's just, it's all this nonsense before and after. When it's a war, it's, you know, it's in the middle of the war, you can watch it on telly.
True.
You get results. True. You know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like a test match or something. But it's all this rubbish before and after. It drags on.
This recent war seemed, I thought, just generally, it was better presented than the previous one. Because I remember the first Gulf War, it was often during the night. And
disappointing.
I couldn't stay up.
Yeah, because I think the American had rights to it, like the Tyson fight. So we had to get it at 2 in the morning.
Exactly.
Which is annoying. They had, you know, their prime time in that.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
a lot of it was in black and white when the bombs went in. So,
this time there seemed a lot more colourful.
Yeah, it's much better coverage. I think there should win awards.
Yeah, well, I'd like
for
to see
it. So, like Channel 4 won for cricket.
Yeah, I mean, a few times as well, I was quite pleased to see they actually had footage of the bombs exploding.
Yeah. No, good. Well done.
Generally, you know,
good on you. Well done. Good on you.
Yeah,
costs a lot though, doesn't it?
It isn't a costly
thing. Wars a lot more when you got something like, you know, a Jimmy Carr game show, which probably costs about $100,000.
Yeah,
like half an hour of war costs millions.
It's almost
as
expensive as like Terminator 3 or something.
Yeah. But I mean, you know.
But then you know,
you got a variety.
Exactly.
Sorry, Steve, you're talking, mate.
Well, no, I just wanted to make sure you're aware that the World Elephant Polo Championships have taken place.
I did get it.
You're
I think I mentioned
that.
It on. Yeah, yeah, we won, didn't we?
England won.
Yeah.
Well, my question is, where have they been practicing?
I don't know.
Do you remember ever at school anyone ever saying to you, are you interested in playing polo with elephants?
Do you reckon it was five blokes in pith helmets kept sneaking into a whipsnade?
Possibly.
What are you doing, lads? We're practicing. Get down.
Yeah.
Get off them elephants.
Yeah. I didn't even know we had a team. I can't believe it.
No,
but it's like Johnny Wilkinson and the rugby lads, they're going to get MBEs, all sorts. The elephant boys, the elephant polo boys, nothing.
They're going to get nothing.
I haven't seen the
but,
sun
you know,
talking
about
them.
To be fair, it's not like horse polo where I don't think there's a stick long enough. I think the elephants kick it, don't they?
I think you might be right. I think they're not allowed to use their tusks.
They'd burst it, weren't they?
Start again.
Raheem!
Yeah.
What do you mean the elephants kick it?
All right, I've opened a can of worms here. You know, normal polo on a horse, they have like, mallets. Yeah, they whack them, right? But I think it's obviously they're too high up. I think, I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure they just train the elephant to kick it.
So what, like, why are people something about? Why not just let them have a kick about without.
And why does horse racing have to have a jockey? Well, they just let the horses go, on you, okay, lads, on you, no cheating, on your marks, get set, go, you, no, get back here, get back here. Brilliant. Okay. Play a record.
Ryan Adams?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, this is absolutely fantastic.
His version of Wonderwall, if you've not heard it yet, you'll be loving it.
You'll be loving this. This is the Best Of Show on XFM 104.9, I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
I hope you're enjoying the best of.
There's a fella who, was in a coma for 20 years.
Hmm.
Just, they kept, like, taking him through, like, the normal day. They'd take him to Alton Towers and stuff. Doesn't know anything about it. Just kept going through the motions. Don't know if they kept charging him. kept putting him through all that. He eventually came out of it. 20 years.
And went, stop taking me to Horton Towers, it's shit.
I just thought, imagine how much post making, he had.
Eh?
How much post.
Oh,
did you read about that guy in the paper, Carl? He, sorry, on the internet. he in about, I think it was about 1984, 85, he had a terrible car accident.
But this must be it.
He went into a coma.
This must be what he's talking about.
Well, they didn't take him to Alton Towers.
Of course they didn't. But you've got to try and decipher the truth from the conjecture, from the thing that he, I mean, don't forget, Carl says, realises that he's had a dream. He talks to Suzanne and goes, that was good, wasn't it, last night we were in the plane? She goes, no, that's a dream. He goes, oh yeah, where's my car, thanks. You've got to, you know what I mean, I can now decipher what he's actually seen, what he's read.
Well, go on, what did you...
Well, I'm assuming it's the same guy.
It is the same guy.
It was a guy in some small American town, yeah. And he'd had a car crash and he'd gone into a coma and his wife had left him. She'd gone on with her life because he'd been in a coma since then. And he had just woken up recently.
Marriage wasn't working.
Marriage wasn't working. He just wasn't paying enough attention. he actually had, she was pregnant at the time, and so now his daughter, his daughter is basically the same age as he was when he went into the coma. And he's just started coming around, he's just started making jokes. He says, they said, how do you feel? He said, horny, which I thought was quite witty for a man who'd been in a coma for however many years. But anyway, yeah, so he's slowly trying to rebuild what life he can.
That's
what do you make of that though? Because the thing is that he's missed. Imagine what he's missed, Carl. Imagine the music that he's missed. The
Live
TV
Aid.
Programs,
missed Live
news.
Aid.
Live Aid.
He missed Phil Collins
Girls.
Playing in two continents in one day.
Which, frankly, I'd be devastated if I discovered
missed,
that.
Missed
happened.
Bros.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he doesn't. So he put on ripped jeans and they go passe.
They just have to send him a series of those I Love 1986
exactly.
programs with Kate Thornton filling him in on what he's
exactly.
missed.
Peter Kay reminding him of Space Hoppers.
Yeah,
he remembers
Richard
those.
Talking rubbish.
Yeah. So,
extraordinary, though, isn't it, Carl, to think?
Mm.
No, obviously.
So, had he aged much? Because he hadn't had any problems or anything, no worries.
Well, he probably wouldn't have, physiologically, he probably wouldn't have the wear and tear of a 43-year-old man. Because he wouldn't have had sun, he wouldn't have had sort of nicotine, beer.
Unless they were just feeding that to him.
Anyway, still. Yeah. Yeah.
So you feel groggy though, wouldn't you?
Yeah, you might feel a bit groggy. Yeah, yeah.
Well, he's not fully back to normal. I mean, there's some kind of residual brain damage.
Yeah,
but nevertheless, he can form sentences. He's got no real memory, so he can't remember a lot of things.
It was just when I saw.
Carl, have you been in an accident? The brilliant Blur, Out of Time on XFM 104.9.
One of my favourite singles of the year, and that's another thing, we'll be playing our favourite singles of the year, as well as our favourite clips of our own show.
Rick, I imagine if people have got a bit of Christmas money, they're wondering what they can spend it on.
Office DVD.
Well, other than that, these guys have got some ideas.
What, adverts?
Yeah.
Brilliant. XFM. Placebo. Bitter End on XFM 104.9. This is pre-recorded. We recorded this a couple of weeks ago, before Christmas. I hope you had a great Christmas. If you didn't, not our fault, really, is it?
Nothing to do with us.
Wouldn't have thought we'd have.
We're well over time, because we've got plenty of cash now, thanks to a lot of you who probably bought the Office DVD.
Yeah.
Probably got
and
that
if you haven't
stocking.
Yet, and you've maybe got vouchers or money, still available.
Still there in the shops.
Still available. You can still make it the best-selling DVD of all time.
Please, please.
Please do. Yeah. Please do. I'll tell you what you want to here, though, before you make your mind up. I'll tell you what, if you like this next clip, go and buy the Office DVD. I think you wrote it's a brilliant clip.
It's the one where we talk about, well, it's self-explanatory.
Yeah.
What's the best job you've ever had still, Carl? Talk about it. Is it still
paper
the
round.
Is it still the paper round?
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
No, it was good, though. If you look at it, like, you know, what I liked about it, you're your own boss.
No, you're not. You're not your own boss.
No,
the news agent is your boss.
All right. But then once you get out and you've got your papers and that, you sort of, you're on your
do
own.
Do
you
want as long as you deliver the papers exactly to the places he said you are in the time he said?
Yeah.
It's freedom, isn't it? Any jobs you wouldn't do? I just thought of one that you wouldn't do.
Go on.
With your sort of mild homophobia.
Well, I'm not.
Proctologist.
What's that?
Basically sticking your finger at other people's arses.
Right, well, I wouldn't do that, no. Why have you got to do that?
What do you mean, why have you got to do
well,
that?
Why does anyone need that doing?
Does they got to look if they've got an arse ache or something?
Which trainee doctor makes that their speciality?
Do you know what I mean? That must be, right, we got our place for apologies, and it's you, Meadows. You yeah. came last.
Oh, seriously, what? I'm not the arse doctor, am I?
Yeah. You came last.
Oh, I'm a bum GP. I can't believe it.
Yeah, yeah. You got to, oh, I can't believe this.
Yeah. Tell you a job I don't like.
What?
I wouldn't want to be doing. The woman, there's a little woman who sits in the little snack stall on Finchley Road.
Yeah.
And I don't know how to describe it, really. She is surrounded by snacks. She can't move for snacks. It's
does
like,
it look like American Beauty, but with different...
Not dissimilar to that. Yeah. It's a little hut on the station. Yeah. And it's like, if you go to the seaside, you can put your head through one of those cardboard cutouts and it looks like you're a big fat person or whatever, and you yeah. can have your photo taken. It's like an equivalent of that, but it's just snacks everywhere. She's got bananas up to her chin. She's got chocolate coming down to her eyes, crisps either side of her. She can't move. She can't do 360 degrees. She's like packed in there. I don't think, I don't know how she gets in there.
I think they put her in her first and they put, okay, pour in the bananas.
Yeah.
They go, and then they go pour in the nuts.
She has 2 hours of makeup before
yeah,
they
exactly,
open,
yeah.
dressing her in there. Because I'll ask for something from the fridge and she cannot turn her head to see. She has to go by feel alone, just to feel the fridge and get stuff out and pass it. And often I'll say, that's not what I wanted, but she can, you've got to let her off. It's
oh,
extraordinary.
Dear.
But there's no music playing,
there's
nothing.
Does she have to sell her way out of it?
Exactly.
If it's a slow day, she's stuck yeah. there till the next day.
Yeah, it's like a world-breaking attempt.
Yeah. Carl, what job wouldn't you want to do? Well, any job, you're a lazy...
You're joking, aren't you? I've done loads of stuff. I'm quite happy now doing what I'm doing.
Yeah? You but, look happy.
I
sound happy.
Yeah, I mean, calm down. You on drugs?
I'm all right.
Are you on E?
Happy before. England have won and that. I'm
what?
Happy for them.
Yeah, go on. Happy for them.
I'm happy in that.
Yeah. What do you mean happy for them? We are England. Happy
yeah.
for us.
Yeah.
I mean, we didn't play. I did very little towards it.
No.
It was mainly Johnny Wilkinson.
Yeah, I barely contributed. Switching on the TV was about as much as I did.
Exactly. And shouting, "Come on!"
Yeah.
Talking about jobs and that, though, I was reading the other day about. Like, you know, rubbish jobs that people have had and stuff.
I haven't got time when I work one. I just get on with it. I'm not squiddly diddly. Fingers in pies, different jobs. Go on.
Do you know Ivor the Terrible?
Ivan.
It's
Russian. Yeah, that was the Welsh fella. It was bloody awful, but not as bad as his Russian cousin, Ivan. Yeah. Go on.
He had a fella doing some work for him, right? Yeah. This fella built his house. After it was done, right, the terrible fella was like,
fella Ivan.
He was going, oh, it's brilliant, you've done a good job there.
Yeah.
I don't want you to build another one like that. Took his eyes out. Just
what?
Stopped him making an house like that.
Another one? Blimey.
That's bad, isn't it?
Why didn't he take away his trowel? Then he could have seen yeah. that he couldn't have built a house without a trowel. You can't build a house without a trowel.
Yeah.
I suppose he probably later thought that, once he'd been nicknamed Ivan the Terrible.
Yeah, yeah.
He thought, why? Because you gouge people's eyes out.
Yeah, but I didn't want to build another house.
I know, but...
Take his trowel away. What would I have been then? Well, Ivan the Crafty at most.
Exactly, yeah.
Ivan the Jealous, you know, Ivan yeah. the Spoiled Brat, but...
Yeah.
Gouge someone's eyes. That is bloody terrible. I'm surprised you're not called Ivan the... Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. You're going to get on in history like with Vlad the Impaler.
Yeah.
He's mainly remembered for impaling people.
Yeah. He did a lot of other stuff.
He did a load of great charity work he did.
The impaling
remembered.
Is the thing that's really
yeah.
gone down in history. When were you reading about Ivan the Terrible?
No, it's just
or Ivan the Terrible is the thing you remembered from this informative article.
No, it was just little bits like that. Talking about him, there was a thing about someone who worked for that fella who painted the ceiling.
Sistine Chapel.
Yeah, there was a thing, a woman who worked for him in his house, and,
I love how you assimilate information when it's just bordering on the academic, or just the interesting and true. It's wonderful. Ivor the Terrible gouged someone's eyes out because built him an house. That fella who painted that ceiling had a woman work for him. Imagine if you wrote that down in an essay. Imagine if you wrote that in a school essay.
Well, you'd probably end up with not getting a grade or...
Yeah, or thinking you've turned yeah. up to more than you had.
Exactly. Anyway, the woman who lived with...
Yeah, the woman who lived in a shoe. Go on.
Yeah, there was this woman who lived with him and, she used to, like, you know, go out and do all this shopping and that.
Yeah.
But because she couldn't read or write, he used to have to draw everything that he wanted.
Why couldn't he just tell her?
I don't know.
No, wait. That's an excellent point. Could she talk?
Yeah, but if it's a big list and that, loads of different coloured paints.
But why
and
couldn't
stuff.
She draw on a piece of paper? Why did he have to do it?
Because he's a better drawer, isn't he?
That's the point. That's it. That is. We were just looking for the logic of the story. You found it.
You done it. Play a record.
This is the Best Of Show on XFM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
I hope you're enjoying the Best Of.
I'm amazed that these are the highlights and that we've strung it out this long, Rick.
But the good thing about this is, we're not here, we recorded this a couple of weeks ago, just the links, right? This has taken us about 10 minutes for the whole show. We get paid the same. Why don't we do this every week?
That's a great idea. High five.
Right. Listen to this clip, it's brilliant.
I think that my new TV is too big, Rick.
I said that.
I know,
when you
I don't
it.
Know I was thinking.
But I can't believe it. He talked about this buying it. He's got a bit of cash now, of course. And what is it? 42 inches?
Mm.
42 inch plasma screen. What did it cost you? £3,000 or something?
Oh, don't tell me. That's
wow,
huge.
It's ridiculous.
£3,500.
Big spender. Of course it's too big.
Well, I can't get far enough back in my room, in my living room for it.
You know, it, 40, you're meant to be, I think, four times the screen size away from it.
Really?
To get out from the air. So that's four times 42 inches you're meant to be sitting away from it, which is impossible.
Yeah. Well, I'll have to just get friendly with the neighbours.
Yeah, watch it through a hat.
If that's the case, though, aren't you better off just getting a portable?
What?
I don't understand that rule. What are you saying?
Well, you're meant to be four times the screen size away from the TV.
But that's then what's the point in having a big telly if you've got to keep moving further back? Get a portable.
And sit right next to it.
Do see your point. Why do people go to the cinema then?
Did you see films that aren't out yet?
Fair enough, he's got you there.
Dom.
I tell you this though, I had it delivered and are you supposed to tip delivery men?
Of course you
I
are.
I don't know. You
well,
said,
well, if
I've never had anything delivered before. I've never
well,
spent
no,
that
not
much
if
money.
It, not if it's a courier with an envelope, but if it's a bloke who's struggled up the stairs,
I held the door open for
fat blokes with a fridge, then give him a fiver for a drink.
But the problem was, I didn't realise, and I was thinking to myself, I wonder if I've got to tip him. And the guy was leaving, and my mobile phone went off in my pocket.
Yeah.
And I reached in to get it. He put his hand out, thinking it was a tip. I went, it's just my phone.
Oh.
And I felt terrible after he left. I didn't know. What was I going to do? Run down the street and offer him a fiver?
No.
No, of course not.
No.
I'm not made
no.
of money. I just spent it all on TV.
Yeah, I've got no money, mate. Yeah. I just spent it all on this. I had to clean out my jar,
exactly.
Everything, the drawers.
Yeah, I'd take some bottles back.
The
problem was it took me forever to wire it in. I thought, I'm not going to pay for someone to wire it up, you know. So it took me about 3 hours to wire it in, and it was huge. And I got it switched on, and the first program that was on when I got it wired in was Bargain Hunt. I'll tell you this, David Dickinson's tan almost took me eyeballs out.
Yes,
it was incredible. It was like X-rays.
So close.
Glow.
I know, a huge plasma screen with this orange thing coming out, and he keeps turning to the camera,
course,
doesn't he? Just
grin.
To get you. Yeah, he turns away. You get a bit close. They go, "What's he doing?" He just turns around, takes the cornea off.
What do you think, Bargain Hunter? Bargain Hunter.
Oh dear, well, that's why I'd buy a plasma screen to watch Bargain Hunt.
I mean, it's ludicrous. This is the problem. Is because what do you watch?
I mean, have you watched anything that's been worth having?
The only thing I've watched really worth watching.
24.
Well, yeah, 24 works great. But also films, obviously, that's the main reason I bought it, because films just look amazing on there.
Yeah, DVD on the plasma screen.
So if you're into films and that, it's just that I only, you know, I've just got the five channels and flicking about, and I'm not impressed. I mean, I can understand why more people listen to radio and stuff.
Yeah.
Cause,
well, not this one, but go on.
Well, when was it? When was, the last time I sort of sat down and had time, because I'm always busy doing stuff and that.
Sure. Moaning takes up about 3 hours a day.
Mm. When did Wimbledon finish?
A couple of weeks ago.
Right. Found myself sat there, right? I'm not having a go. I know we stopped Cheeky Freak of the Week and all that, right? So
Christ.
I'm not going to be having a go.
Christ.
I sat there.
I'm scared.
No, I'm not having a go. You've always got to remember that.
Go
I'm
on.
Just
get on with it. Get on with it. I'll apologise after.
I'm just saying, watching Wimbledon, it wasn't, you know, one of the major games. It was, little fellas in a wheelchair having a game.
Little fellas in a wheelchair.
Right.
But for me, I mean, you know, great, they're doing a sport and everything. Don't put it on the telly.
What was up with it?
There wasn't like a rally going on.
Oh, God.
No, do you know what I mean? Do you know normally
Christ.
Like with the not Tim Henman, but with some of the other with some of the other players and that, they're playing for ages, aren't they? It's like, oh, who's going to win this and that?
Yeah.
None of that. It was just like, hit it, net.
Oh, Christ! Oh, God! I don't know what to do!
And people were, like, sat there watching it as well, when they've got other games going on in there. That's what I couldn't understand. If you've paid your money to get in...
Yeah.
I mean, like I say, good on them if they'd... Do you know what I mean? But it would have been...
And they all start first in the marathon.
I just thought it would have, you know, give them a game of swing ball or something.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
No, yeah, I understand.
Oh, God! Yeah.
There's never anything
XFM
on.
In the community.
Let's play a tune. Ricky Gervais, Ricky Don Gervais, XFM.
Don't put my name to this last link. Don't put my name to this last link.
Ricky.Gervais, XFM.co.uk.
Oh,
Magic, God. Virgin, if you're listening, we are available probably sooner than we thought.
That was Radiohead and There. We're not here, alright? Pre-recorded. Coming up is one of Carl's little film things where he puts himself into a film. It's his favourite film. It's Kez. Enjoy it.
I love the fact that in pole position, in positions one and two of his favourite films of all time, is The Elephant Man and Kez.
Yeah.
That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Go on.
Alright. Am I leaving the mics open a bit when this is going out?
Yeah, let's have a listen.
Yeah. Alright. Don't talk then, right?
Just put that hot dog down, Rick.
And this is the bit in Kez where it's the teacher and he gets up and he has to
Glover.
Talk.
What's his name? Is it Brian Glover?
No, no.
No.
No, it's What's the other teacher.
The other one.
Anyway.
All right. Go on.
Alright. So, here we go.
Things that have actually happened.
I'll get
another one. What about you, Casper? Casper!
Alright.
Alright?
Alright.
You haven't been listening to a word I've said, have you?
Yeah, I heard some of it. Yeah, you.
Some of it.
Just
stand up. Always somebody, isn't there? Right, now you're going to tell us a story about yourself.
What sort of story?
I want you to think of an incident that happened to you sometime in the past that is true, and that you think will interest the rest of the class. All right?
Right. What about I work on a radio show at the weekend.
Well, are you going to tell us about it?
I'll just do. It's 2 hours, and it's with Ricky Gervais and Stephen Merchant, and just sort of play music and, you know, tell stories and stuff.
Kind of stories.
Well, whatever. Like last week, it was science. We're talking about this lad who was growing. A knob on his arm, so it's weird. It's tricky, sir, because, like, with Ricky, he gets bored quick and he won't listen to the stories and he'll start squeezing the head.
All right, I'm not interested in what he does.
That isn't normal, is it, sir, that? I mean, it sure is a bit gay.
Is he?
Just messes about, though, do you know what I mean? I try and, like, come up with good stuff. Like monkey news and like quizzes and stuff, but then he'll just, you know, Ricky will just mess about. I mean, on Saturday he did it again. He squoze me head.
How do you spell that?
Squoze.
S-Q. Oh,
excellent.
Well, you're going to show us more. It's a new word to me.
Squoze is S-Q-U-O-Z-E.
Right, tell us what it is.
It's when he gets me head. And he puts one hand on the back of it, right? Yeah. And he puts the other hand on the front of it, and he just sort of swivels it.
Swivel, right down the front.
Well, swivel's not a... It's spelled S-W-I-D... Like that.
How many times a day?
How many times a day does he swoze it? It depends what time he, you know, what time he gets in. If he gets in about 12:30, he could get a good 3 in. But I think, you know, I don't really want to talk about.
Don't you? Well done, Billy. Big hand of applause.
That is, the effort.
Yeah.
Wow. That's the best thing you've ever done, Carl.
Cent in Da Club on XFM 104.9.
We're playing our favourite singles of the year.
Yep.
And we're looking back over some of our favourite clips of the year.
I'm Ricky Gervais, Steve Merchant, and Carl Pilkington. Not done a lot. Maybe you should earn your money as you get to Mondays off for this 2 hours of nonsense.
What are you on about? I've done loads of stuff.
Yeah.
Right. Same old, same old.
Yeah.
Let's have something new, something fresh.
Well, I've been looking around, right, on the internet for stuff.
Yeah. On the internet?
Yeah. Your Bible, where you get all your information about the world and the universe and morality from.
And you know, like, how I always say to you, I don't really read that much of it, I just read the headline.
Perfect.
Right?
Yeah.
Anna Nova has sort of nicked that idea to grab you.
Nicked what idea?
Well, to sort of get to the meat straight away at the top. Do you know what I mean? The headline to the story and everything.
What?
Right, these are stories.
But the headlines already existed, that was why you thought that was gonna
be. Not like this, though.
All right.
Headline. Well, these are all headlines, right? Vibrating shoes could stop elderly falling. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, God.
You don't Vibrating need... shoes could stop elderly falling.
Yeah, that's the story. You don't need to read on. That's what I'm saying.
Well, right? Could you read on anyway?
Can't be bothered.
Read on anyway.
Well,
read...
you have a look at that in a bit, right?
Oh, so this is frustrating radio if you're sitting at home.
No,
well, it's not on. They've turned it off.
If you want to know more, you know where to go. That's what I'm saying. That's what they should do in the news. Get the news done in,
bong.
In a minute. There's
a good story about Iraq.
Right.
Bong.
Right,
have look it up. Look it up on the internet. Right. Anna Nova.
Give us another bong.
Bong.
Family sick of living on Butthole Road.
Brilliant. Oh, brilliant. Bong.
Man wears same shoes for 60 years.
Oh, bong.
This isn't that good. Some fella pulls a train with his teeth.
Yeah. And in lighter news.
I know that. Triple Donald, this one isn't very good.
And the last one, man fails to break clothes pegs on face record. She's always good. Well, that's the one I did read on about.
I love that out of all those. That's the one he read on about. Go on then.
Just,
why is that news? He fails to make a record.
Mm.
So did I today.
I know, yeah.
I failed the long jump record today.
Yeah.
Didn't even take part.
No. I was rubbish.
But what are the rules on world records and that?
I don't know if there are rules. There are certain things you can't. I mean, it's the Guinness Book of Records, isn't it, really, that's the arbiter in it?
Yeah, but is there anything, if you said you wanted to do it, would they say, well, you can't do that?
Yeah, they've stopped some gluttony records, obviously things that are in danger, anything that's illegal, yeah, anything that's immoral.
Yeah, like that American serial killer that just got discovered,
yeah,
having killed 47 women. I don't think he can make that into the Guinness Book of Records.
No, because people would be trying to beat it, won't they?
But there was some other story about a fella eating watches and that. That can't be good for you. So why don't they say, look, don't do that, do something else.
He wanted to stay regular.
Do you know what I mean? I just wondered
what
if
do you mean
he's
any... eating watches?
He just said he was eating watches. He got about three in about a minute.
How did he time it?
Do you know what I mean though? And then the other thing is, the one that I was reading, the world record with the fellow who's pulling a train with his teeth.
Mm.
Does that make any difference? That he's done it with his teeth.
What do you mean?
Well, what difference does it make?
Well, isn't it? It's quite hard to pull a train with your teeth, I imagine.
Well, it's pretty hard to pull a train. All I'm saying is it because he couldn't beat the fella who's pulling it with his hands?
Well, this is my point. I think there was one bloke with a record for the running backwards 100 metres was sort of like 11 and a half seconds. And I was thinking, turn around, you'd probably have a really good go at that. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's sort of like doing a marathon with a milk bottle on your head. Take the milk bottle off and see how fast you can go, you twat.
But you can just tweak it. Like, the fella who has done the pegs on the face, right?
Yeah.
His name's Gary Stretch Turner, right?
Right.
So, he's sort of cheating already if he's got a stretchy head, right?
But you are, right, you are one of the most stupid humans I've ever met.
Well, get me in the book. Yeah. Right? Well, listen. So, Gary Stretch Turner, right? His record is 153 pegs.
Yeah.
He did it again, and he only got 150 on. So, he hasn't broke his own record.
Right.
But what I'm saying is, if he tweaked it a bit more, would that make a new record?
What?
Well, if he said, I've got 150 pegs on, but at the same time as eating a burger.
I see what you mean, yeah. He'd be the, world record breaker for pegs and eating burgers at the same time.
Yeah, just change it a bit. If you know you're not going to make it, just do something else.
I'm assuming the rules are set at the beginning, Carl. That's it. That's where they say, right, you're just going to do the pegs thing. You're not going to introduce burgers halfway through, are you? Definitely not. And then they have a go.
I was on one leg, not interested. How many pegs? 150.
Can I just ask very briefly, I was quite interested by the family had to move because they lived on Butthole Road.
Yeah, I quite like that
one. I don't know if I've told you before, Rick, where I used to live. I'm not going to tell you the name of the street that I used to live on, because not on air, because my parents still live there and I don't want you know. But I'm going to write it for you now. This is the name, the genuine name of the street I used to live on. Just imagine when you're at school.
Yeah.
And like in class, for instance, in French, you've got to say, you've got to answer where you live.
Yeah.
J'habite, wherever.
Yeah.
That's the name. This is actually the name of the street we lived on.
No, it's not.
I swear to God.
That is...
I, absolute right. I could phone my father now and he could confirm that for
you.
No, I swear
because he doesn't want
to... That's... God. And I'll tell you that...
What, but listen, do you know what worries me? It's the apostrophe S.
I know.
Because that's blatant.
Yes. Amazing, isn't it?
That is incredible.
But imagine how embarrassing
that was. So if I look that up in the Bristol...
You will find that in the Bristol A to Z. I swear
to God. That is really... Why have you never told me that before?
I can't believe I haven't.
That's
incredible. I'm still embarrassed now. Do you know if whenever I have to phone up, if I have to give that address, I always spell it instantly.
Really?
Like somehow that'll hide it, that'll disguise the name.
But I can't get over that.
Anyway, if you perhaps live in Tits Avenue, you know, or
Wankling Drive.
Wankling Drive, just get in touch. Let us know. We're not really interested.
This is the Best Of Show on XFM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
I hope you're enjoying the Best Of. I know what you're thinking. If this is the best, my Christ, what was the rest like? Well, we'll be back in a week's time, so you can judge it for yourself live. But anyway, in the meantime, this is one of the best clips I've ever heard.
Oh, I'm laughing just thinking about what it might be.
He said this, you know, oh God, it's like a child or a cat when it's confused. He went, Steve reckons, in ancient Greece, right, it was better to shag a bloke than a woman. And I went, well, yeah, I mean, that's about the male being sort of a first-class citizen, much better, wasn't it, an aspiration
the
to sleep with a beautiful man than a beautiful woman.
Women were lower-class citizens, so therefore men were seen as higher class. So to have sexual relations with a man, was there was no shame in that.
No.
In fact, it was looked upon
and
as
I said, well, it was, you know, ancient Rome. I said, you know, Nero, he used to sit in his big jacuzzi and he used to get, you know, pretty boy men to just go into the water and just nibble at his testicles while he was having a watch.
He didn't do that.
He did. Yeah.
And he's not a gay fella.
No, well, no. I mean, you know, I don't know about Nero, but I mean, it wasn't a case of a big delineation between what was heterosexual and what was gay. It was just, you know, whatever you...
So what did this fella do then? This one who's having his...
Well, he was pretty much top boy, Nero, for a while.
He was in charge.
And, you know, and you did what you're told, if Caesar or.
But why were people going round there? Why didn't they go? Oh.
No, they weren't dropping in. It wasn't like the doors opening. I was just going to see what Nero's doing. You'd have probably been like a delivery boy or a stable boy or something, you know. And you'd have popped round there and you'd have gone, there, right, Nero, as the tablets of stone you wanted. And they go, Pilkington, why you are here? Pop on. I don't know why he's French.
What is that?
I don't know why he's French. Just pop under the water and nibble at my testicles and you'd have done it.
Because he was Nero.
I wouldn't.
He would have.
Well, there's no way I would have done.
Yeah, well, you would
have. What have I done? I've dropped a pizza off.
you pull around to Nero's place with a pizza.
I've dropped a pizza.
I'd say I've done my job. Right?
Yeah.
That's not the sort of tip I wanted.
No, he'd have said, get the little baldy chap to nibble on my testicles and you'd run the water.
No, I wouldn't have done it.
Can I just say this, Steve? Not only would you be nibbling his testicles, you'd have been going mad. You'd have been noshing him just for extra. You'd have been doing everything he wanted. You'd have been going, he'd have gone, I didn't ask you to do that. You'd have been going mental. They'd have been chewing, slurping, smacking, poking. He'd have chopped, you'd have gnawed his packet off. You'd think you're eating Walker's crisps. There'd be bubbles, there'd be flood. Oh, it'd be horrible.
That was Bowie and Waterloo Sunset. Love that. Love the original. Love Bowie. Bowie was my gig of the year. These are my singles of the year. These are our clips of the year. I'm Ricky Gervais with me, Stephen Merchant. We're just picking some lovely little bits and pieces.
Do you remember when we talked about this?
That's the sort of thing I think we need now, right? We've covered a lot of stuff.
What, education?
But teaching, yeah.
Well, okay, what do you want to know?
Don't know.
Have you got something? Can you educate us on anything?
I've been reading bits
and
bobs.
We bring back just for one night only, educating Ricky?
Oh, I'm excited.
Yeah? Do you think it warrants that?
I don't know enough about it. Do you know what I mean?
About what?
It sounds perfect. Play the jingle.
Educating Ricky. He's getting smarter.
A couple of things happened in the week that I read about.
Okay.
Keeping up on what's going on and that.
Sure.
Yeah.
One was about that Galileo fella.
Okay.
Was it about 1636?
Was it? I think it might have been earlier.
Bad.
Go on.
Did some stuff with light and that.
He did lots of physical experiments, yeah.
Is that it then, Carl, is it? He did some stuff with light and that.
What did he do with light? What was that?
I think he invented the first...
Telescope?
Telescope. So I think it's a particular lens out of that, he did experiments where he dropped two different, weighted, balls from Pisa. And, they hit the ground at the same time, showing that doesn't matter. The weight doesn't matter. But air resistance does and stuff like that.
I think he probably explained it a bit better than that.
Yeah, but I'm talking to Carl.
Sure. But did they need to know
He's
stuff-
He's just thinking about pizza.
Yeah.
Did they need to know stuff like that back then?
What do you mean, did they need to know stuff like that? It's just-
There weren't people going around going, I've got to drop these two things off the Leaning Tower of Pizza. I just don't know which one's gonna land first.
Yeah, I need to know. What do you need to
know
that?
Bring me Galileo.
Yeah.
It's for a bet.
Yeah.
No, but if I was knocking about then, I'd be like, stop messing with that. We need a telly. Or, you know what I mean?
I bet he thinks the Flintstones is real.
I know.
That'd be brilliant. That's what I'd do if I was a caveman. I'd make a telly out of rock.
Yeah.
And a pelican
and a
cement mixer.
Just ran along the room with.
Exactly. Yeah, we need a car.
Yeah.
Well, we haven't really got the internal combustion engine. Can you stick your feet through the bottom? Yeah? Just get me a car, for Christ's sake.
Anyway, so I learnt that. And then,
What? He learnt his name.
Yeah.
Other people I learnt their name off this week.
Oh, if a chimp could watch telly. Go on, Carl, go on.
And there was also a fella in the week who said, that women shouldn't be wearing trousers.
Why?
Because they don't look good in them. What do you think? What do you think about that?
It's rubbish.
Yeah.
These are the only things that have caught your eye. Over the last couple of weeks. This is the entire news.
Galileo did something with light. A French fella said women shouldn't wear trousers. See, that to me wouldn't pass as education.
It's not education.
I don't know where you could ever use that. I don't know when that would ever be applicable to life.
I just like reading stuff that sort of reminds me of, do you know what I mean? If I read it and it gets me thinking, I think that's a good little piece.
But surely, can't you just sort of like sit near something that vibrates to keep your brain going? Or shake your head every now and again? I mean, what does this do? You mean it makes you start using your brain?
But what aspect of the, a Frenchman said women shouldn't wear trousers, got your mind working? What questions were you
asking?
Because
I thought that's a bit daft, isn't it? Right?
Yeah.
Okay, it ends there with me. There's nothing else, there's nowhere else for me to go on that.
He closes
your mind's
the gap.
Still worrying.
Yeah, go on, what did you think? Let's go through this. Oh, I wish we could download his thoughts. Just watch it.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be great, like a DVD? Imagine that extra footage on the Office DVD.
Yeah, Carl's brain.
That would be
with
amazing.
Commentary.
Oh, what with I a mean commentary. Is, go on.
Women wearing trousers and that, right? On the estate that I grew up in, right? There's a woman about 4 houses down, right?
Right.
Rough. Now, she used to wear leggings.
Yes.
No, they're a bad idea.
They are a terrible idea. I agree with you there, Carl. If you're a lady of
what
the
colour?
Normo
were,
persuasion...
Were they pink?
No, they were sort of black, but with all bits on them.
Oh, right.
Do you know what I mean?
What, toast and
just
horse
bits.
Droppings? Yeah, go on, yeah.
And she used to, she's quite a big woman.
Sure.
Pauline Quirk, I think described her as.
Looked like a light bulb when she was
bending over.
It is
those kind of women
that
are attracted to leggings.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
They are drawn to them like a moth.
She
used to wear them, and that's what I remember when I read this piece. And she used to work on one of those sex line things.
Right.
Right. She used to do that. But
what was she, an engineer?
The The weird thing, the weird thing with her was, she had big eyelids.
Right. Go on.
That were too big, and this is what I was thinking.
What do you mean she had big eyelids? How big do eyelids have to be for you to go, they're big eyelids? What was she shoplifting with them? Would she come out of Dixon's with, like, radio stored in them? What do you mean she had big eyelids?
It was another one of them popular things around our way, do you know, like,
what do you mean popular things? They go, oh, I'll tell you what, they're all the rage, can I get some big eyelids, please?
No, it was just, like, one of them things that people suffered with. Just big eyelids, they could hardly open their eyes.
That's one of the popular things around where I grew up. People had big eyelids, they could hardly open their eyes. What does that mean? What sort of freak town were you born in? You had webbed feet people with big heads, you got women with big eyelids. What does big eyelids mean?
Are you confusing her with the horse?
Yeah. Did she have hooves? Look, what?
Just anyway, so there's this big eyelidded woman with the legs.
And that's what I'm saying to you, though. That's when I read that story with people with trousers, I went from that
to a woman who used to have big eyelids. I still on the point.
But then, and also the other bloke who had the eyelid problem was a mate of mine.
Right, yeah.
His dad had it, and same problem, massive eyelids.
I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means.
I used to say to my mum, I'm going round to Dave's house.
Yeah,
and
or Drew
say,
Pete,
well,
as you call him.
That's all right, but make sure his dad doesn't take you out in the car, because he could hardly he could hardly see. He had to have his head.
He had to tilt his head back to keep his eyes open.
Sure! Didn't he have a couple of matches with him at all times?
Oh. What a load of gobbledygook. This began as educating Ricky.
I know, it's like, he was thinking with eyelids.
But it's like, you're supposed to make that leap as well.
Yeah.
If I mention the trousers, Ricky will probably be thinking about people with big eyelids and women wearing leggings.
Play a record, Carl.
This is the Best Of Show on XFM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais, with me Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
I hope you're enjoying the Best Of.
Like I said to you, though, the reason I did this was to get that kitchen, right? Now,
brilliant.
As we speak now, right, builder's in the flat. He's been annoying me.
Of course he has. What's he been doing?
When he turned up on Monday, right, wanders in. And the first thing he says to me is, said, the pub across the road, is it any good? I said, well, it doesn't matter, does it? You're working on the kitchen.
Think of saying that to a builder. Probably making conversation. Probably meant, do they do a toasted sandwich? Because I've got a half-hour lunch break, not an hour, like Carl Bilkington. So, I'll pop over there and get a nice, cheese and tomato sandwich.
Is that genuinely what you said to him?
Yeah.
So Suzanne had a go at me saying, why have you said that? He hasn't even started on it yet.
I cannot believe that.
You're unbelievable, Carl. And you say it's us that are rude, crass,
I wasn't
thoughtless.
Being rude. I just was letting him know. Do you know what I mean? I know what
he knows what he was there for. He had it down on his little docket. Do the kitchen this week. He didn't come there and go, what did I come out for? Was it to go to the pub for a week?
Why am I wearing these overalls?
Yeah. Who's the little bald mank twat insulting me? Let me just check. Let me call the head office.
I wasn't having a go, though. I mean, they should have finished it yesterday. And they're there now. Right, on their own. And what annoyed me is they turned up late today.
Hold on, Carl. I've just realised something. They're probably listening to the radio. This, I assume, tuned to XFM, isn't it, in your kitchen?
Yeah, but they don't know it's me, do they? Do you know what I mean?
No. They'd go, he's got a whiny mank voice as well. So's the bloke who owns this place. And the bloke who owns this place, when I said, what's that pub like across the road, said, well, you won't be bothering that, he's working on this. No, he won't be able to put two and two together, will he? You've suddenly, the penny's dropped, doesn't it? You've suddenly realised, look at his face!
Yeah.
He's suddenly realised they might know it's him!
And they could be listening, and they're going to clean you out, mate.
Oh, if you are the builder working in, where is it? I won't say the address, but it's
Central London, isn't it? Go mental. Have whatever you want.
Opposite that pub that you like, that you're.
It'll probably be in there now, so he won't be listening.
Oh, insulting. You know insulting a British workman.
He should have been
in today. Mental.
He should have been at 8 this morning,
just
which annoyed
go
me anyway.
Mental.
Why? I really don't understand why they've got to start so early, right?
Yeah.
But he said he'll be there for 8, turned up at 9:30, right? Wanders in. And what annoys me is, he could have left all this downstairs. He had a paper under his arm, one of those crossword books, and a pot noodle. Now, I'm not being funny, but most of them take quite a bit of time. A crossword book, he's not happy with just the one that's in the paper.
If you're listening, if you are the builder that's listening now, doing Carl's flat, what about pissing in the laundry basket?
That was, Jane's Addiction. This is the Best Of Show on XFM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais with me, Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
This was a clip show. We recorded this a couple of weeks ago. I hope you had a Merry Christmas. It's not over yet, because tonight at 9:50 is the second part of The Office Christmas Specials. It's brilliant. Watch it. And we'll be back next week live. I'm Ricky Gervais with me, Stephen Merchant. Bye.
Have a great new year. Probably you're thinking, Rick, isn't it time that we do our usual roundup of what's been happening in the news?
Yeah.
Which we always do every week.
Yeah.
We always do something, which is, I mean, basically, if you're listening and you're a new listener, say you work at a newspaper, we always try to be informative, just try and put stuff out there that just educates people, informs people.
What are you thinking? Well, I said Monkey News is coming up, but what have you got?
No, I was just looking on the net there and just found a couple of quite important news stories, probably worth mentioning. Policeman caught photographing. I don't know why it makes me laugh. It's just the phrasing, I suppose. It's a headline. Policeman caught photographing up woman's skirt.
No, he wasn't up there taking a picture of Big Ben.
No.
He wasn't going, can I just sit up here? I'm just going to take a picture of that seagull over there.
No.
He was facing the camera up a woman's skirt.
He was indeed.
Right.
A policeman in Japan is facing disciplinary measures after he was caught photographing up a woman's skirt with a hidden camera while on duty. The 42-year-old sergeant, who's not been named, used a digital camera to secretly snap the shots when the woman was reporting a stolen bicycle.
So he was actually...
He was actually doing his proper job. He'd obviously thought to himself, I'll bring him a digital camera today. On the off chance a beautiful woman comes in to report a crime or robbery, I'll have it ready, I'll have it positioned, you know, in such a way. But this is interesting. This is how he got caught, okay? The woman became suspicious after she saw a flash go off.
Brilliant.
I mean, this
not so secret at all.
Sorry, did I just see your shoe? Your shoe just seemed to just spring into life. There was light. There was light.
Yeah, I think I've had some. Someone set fire to some magnesium that was on the end of it. It won't happen again.
Well, it's only you and I in here, and your shoe was just suddenly lit.
Why are you standing like that? Why is your shoe just sort of like between my feet?
There's no reason.
There's no reason.
Just
where? What did the bike look like? Flash. So, are you taking pictures of me?
No. And no, I'm not. And you should be wearing knickers anyway.
Well, how do you know that?
What?
How did you know I'm not?
How did I know what?
I'm not wearing any...
I didn't know you. I don't know what you've got up there.
Well...
I don't know what it looks like, and I never... There's no way I could. Of course, that would be... It would be roughly that conversation in Japanese.
I know, yeah.
You know, you just mentioned there about, sort of, no knickers and that.
Is this gonna be your Auntie Nora?
No.
Right.
It's just, you know, like, the last flat that I lived in, I always had a good view across the road, and I could see, it was the hairy.
There was the hairy Chinese kid.
Not hairy Chinese kid. He was just a Chinese kid, actually.
Yeah.
Running about. Because that's rare, isn't it? Hairy Chinese kids are very rare, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's only one official sighting, isn't there? In one of those shit little magazines that you buy.
And there was the old woman who didn't move. She was just sat there reading the book all the time.
Who we think possibly died and no one came round for weeks, yeah.
But, and now I've moved, right?
Mm.
And it was quiet for a bit. I always look at what view I'm getting, right? Looks across and it was just sort of empty. Sort of flats ready for people to move in and that, right? Anyway, people are in there now, right? And they've put all the furniture in, but I haven't put any curtains up.
Oh.
Right. So anyway, I'm sort of washing up, just having a look out the window.
Yeah.
Right. Girl sort of wandering about, you know, knickers on. Right?
With no knickers on.
You mean
no knickers? Well, she had a bra on.
Right, okay.
But
she's probably looking for a knicker.
So I thought, oh. And I don't know how long I was looking.
No.
Right. But anyway, she looks across.
Oh, God.
I think she spotted me.
Yeah.
I think, oh, God. I felt really bad.
Yeah.
I said to Suzanne.
Sorry, is this some sort of Peeping Tom confession?
No idea.
Well, it's not. That's the thing, though.
Peepington.
If I was peeping, she was peeping as well, because she was looking over. Works both ways, doesn't it?
Yeah, but all she could see of you was your bald head.
Yeah.
No.
And your hands moving as you were washing up. And some white-looking substance rotting up.
A particularly stubborn stain on this glass.
Yeah.
Oh, God!
Imagine that. Imagine if she looked across. I'm assuming your sink is lower than the window.
But didn't she just, like, just cover up or something? Or she looked back and go, oh, you're looking at my bunny?
Well, the thing I did...
What?
I thought, oh, just sort of dropped me boxer short. Because I thought... Well, Suzanne said, what are you doing?
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
No, just so they can see me, cheeks of me.
What are you talking about?
No, this, because I thought, if she thinks I'm walking about in the nude as well, then we've both got something out of it.
Carl!
This sounds like a bad excuse in court.
I know.
So you were looking at a woman dancing around naked, right? So the only thing you could do was immediately drop your boxer shorts.
So she looked across, saw you fully clothed, saw you took your boxer shorts.
No, she wouldn't have done, because it's sort of just the top half and the sink's at a side angle, so I was sort of looking out.
So she wouldn't have seen your trousers then anyway?
No, she did. I moved in front of the window.
So you then made them. You actually climbed in front of them.
Oh, this is amazing!
So you climbed in front of the window to show off.
No, it wasn't
your naked lower
half. Suzanne said, "What are you doing?"
And I said, bet she did.
What are you looking at?
So I sent you in here to clean
up. What are
you
doing? I'm just taking my trousers down, standing by the window. Why? Because there's a naked woman across the road. What do you think I'm doing, Suzanne? I'm exposing myself while looking at some free fanny.
Leave it.
What's up with you, Suzanne?
Anyway,
Wait a minute, can I just check? A final question. What did the woman across the way, happened? What was her reaction?
I didn't look again. I just thought, you've seen a bit of action as well. We're both happy. Let's leave it.
Brilliant. So were you waddling around like a penguin with your trousers around your ankle?
I just was walking about and Suzanne said, what are you doing? I said, I'll explain to you in a bit, but don't look out the window because then it's
excellent.
Obvious.
Then he sees that she calls her husband to look at Carl walking naked. He goes, oh, she's got a... Quick, Suzanne, get him out. Yeah. There's only one with him. Get some more friends. They've gone one more.